We are continuing with the solution for our second point in region two. At the end of our last video, I asked you to calculate the pH when we added 12.50 milliliters of base. Hopefully what you recognize is that we are still in our buffer zone, and we recognize that because sodium hydroxide is still our limiting reagent. It goes to 0 milliliters. Our amount of change, therefore, is the same across the board, 1.25 for everything. And of course, water is produced, but it doesn't affect our pH. So we still have excess weak acid, the acetic acid, and we have formed the salt of its conjugate base. Because we're still in the buffer zone, we can calculate our pH using our Henderson-Hasselbalch equation. Our pKa is calculated as the negative log of our Ka value. That is still the 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5. And now plugging in our ratio of our base to acid. Remember, our sodium acetate is our base. And our acetic acid is our acid. But of course, because of the same values, this ratio is a value of 1. And remember that the log of 1 goes to 0. If you're not convinced, try that in your calculator. When we plug everything in, we find that we get a pH value of 4.74. Key thing to point out at this point, this specific point in our titration, is where we are relative to volumes. Remember, at the beginning of this set of calculations, we determined our equivalence point volume would be 25 milliliters. Notice where we are right now with the volume of base is exactly half of that. This point in a titration is called the half equivalence point. And for a weak acid, strong base titration, the calculation for pH will always be the pKa. And that is because the amount of base that's formed will always equal the amount of acid that's left over. So a very important point in a titration for a weak acid, strong base. For the rest of this video, we're going to continue on with our next point in the titration. Point three, here we want to know the pH when 25 milliliters of 0.10 molar NaOH is added to 25 milliliters of 0.10 molar acetic acid. Again, if you can't tell from the values right away, we set up our change table to determine our initial quantities of acid and strong base. What we recognize here is that because these two are exactly equivalent, we are at the equivalence point. Remember, the equivalence point is determined where the moles of acid or millimoles of acid exactly equal the moles or millimoles of the base. Because we have 1-to-1 ratio, this is exactly true at the equivalence point. So we only have salt, and I'm going to add in here water in solution. The water, of course, doesn't affect our pH, and so it is the salt at the equivalence point that determines our pH. Recognize here the salt that we're working with is sodium acetate. Because it's a completely soluble salt, it dissociates into sodium and the acetate ion. Remember that our sodium ion is completely neutral, right? It's the cation from a strong base. It is the acetate ion that is basic, and that will hydrolyze. To determine our pH, or to calculate that, we need to write the equation of hydrolysis and then carry on with our calculations. Moving to our next slide, where we have a little bit more information here. Because we're at the equivalence point, we need to find the pH of the salt, and that's true for any titration. Realize we've already done this. We just have one other step that we need to work through. So the dissociation of our salt in a 1-to-1 ratio, in order to finish our calculation, we need to find the concentration of salt. And that's because for our setup, if we were going to carry through with the full setup, we would use an ice table for it. And remember, in ice tables, we have to use concentration. So the concentration of the salt in this example is the 2.5 millimoles that was from our previous change table. That's how much salt was formed. We divide that by the total volume of solution. We have 25 milliliters of acid plus 25 milliliters of base, and that gives us a concentration of 0.05 molar. This is all the calculator gives us. If you were given more digits, you would want to use those full digits. So a reminder to not round early here. To do the full calculation at this point in our titration, the reaction that is shifting our pH is the hydrolysis of the acetate ion. So acetate is reacting with water. Excuse that aqueous in here. That's a typo. We produce acetic acid and the hydroxide ion. And that hydroxide ion is what dictates this being basic. Because we have a basic solution, we need to use a Kb value for our ice table. And remember, for any salt, we always want to perform this calculation to find the opposite K value. So at the beginning of our titration, we were given the Ka value of acetic acid as 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5. But now we want to find the Kb value of the acetate ion. This is our unrounded or extra digits Kb value. On the next slide, I will go through all of the steps of this full calculation. Again, not sure why I have an extra aqueous in here. Sorry about that. So the full steps for our solution would be to write our equilibrium expression, products over reactants. And as a result of our ice table, if we were to set that up, we would get this mathematical equation, x squared over our initial minus x, setting that equal to our calculated Kb value. We now have this mathematical equation to solve, and we're going to take this bottom x out. Because we have such a small K value, this negative 10 is a very small value. Our solution for x, therefore, is going to be our Kb times our initial, in this case, we have a base, initial base concentration. This setup, therefore, is plugging in values. Our Kb value, 5.556, however many extra digits you want in there, times 10 to the minus 10, times our initial concentration of 0.05. When we plug that into our calculator, we get a value of 5.2705 times 10 to the negative 6. Remember from the ice table that our x is a concentration value. And also remember, or helpful to remind ourselves, that that is our hydroxide concentration. Our next step in the calculation would be to find the pOH. So my hydroxide concentration goes in there. pOH is 5.2781. And even if I don't label it as pOH, I should recognize this can't be my final answer of pH because I have a basic salt. And so our pH is 14 minus that final value to give us a pH of 8.72.